today's class we will take up Queeney-McCluskey method. In the previous class we had discussed K-map. So you are now comfortable solving, simplifying a given expression using Karnaugh map. So in the Karnaugh map, it is a graphical method of simplifying a given expression. You plot a K-map depending on the number of variables in a given expression and make entries into the K-map and then try to eliminate the variables by forming groups. So in today's class we will be discussing about Queeney-McCluskey method. So before we take up what Queeney-McCluskey method is, we will try to figure out what are the drawbacks of Karnaugh map. So while solving or simplifying your given expression using K-map, you could note that you could comfortably plot a K-map for a two variable expression, three variable expression and also a four variable expression. But when it comes to more than four variables, things get complex. It is not easy for us to use K-map for simplifying a given expression when number of variables is with the difficulty 5 can be solved, but above 5 it is not easy for us to solve. So what we do is we go with what is called as Queeney-McCluskey method. So the first drawback is, the drawbacks of K-map is, it cannot be easily applied when the number of variables is greater than 5 or greater than 4 or 5. So, and the second one is code implementation of K-map is also difficult. So, if you want things to be implemented using coding, we will go with Queeney-McCluskey method. So, these two drawbacks, one, it cannot be easily applied for more number of variables, and the second one is code implementation is also difficult. So, we go with Queeney-McCluskey method, which overcomes the drawbacks of your K-map. So, in Queeney-McCluskey was designed by Willard Queen and it was extended by McCluskey. So, we give the name, this method has been given, named after them. So, it is called as Queeney-McCluskey method. So, here what we do is, instead of writing down the steps and describing what each step is to, what is to be done at each step, I will take an example here and explain how Queeney-McCluskey can be used to simplify a given expression. So we will straight away take an example and see how Queeney-McCluskey method can be applied to solve or simplify a given expression. So I am taking a four variable expression which is in sum of product forms. The expression is written in min terms. It contains 0, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 10, 12 and 13. So the very step, this particular approach involves two steps. In the very first step, we use a tabular approach and try to identify the prime implicants. And in the second step, once we are up with all the prime implicants, we write one more table wherein we will try to identify essential prime implicants. In the first step, we identify all prime implicants, and in the second step, we extract the essential prime implicants. This is how you apply Queeney-McCluskey method to simplify a given expression. So in the first step, what we do here is, we take all the min terms and its binary representation. So we will write the min terms along with their binary representation. So we have m0, which is 0, 0, 0, m2, 0, 0, 1, 0, m3 is 0, 0, 1, 1. Next we have is m6, 0, 1, 1, 0. We have m7, 0, 1, 1, 1, m8, 1, 0, 0, 0, m10 is 1, 0, 1, 0, m12 is 1, 1, 0, 0, and m13 we have is 1, 1, 0. So we will first write all the min terms and their binary representation, and next what we do is we will sort it in ascending order of the number of ones in their min terms and group them according to the number of ones in each midterm. So we will sort that. We will sort all the midterms in the ascending order of number of ones in each midterm. So what we do is, we consider group G naught, wherein we have all zero number of ones. M naught, we have only M naught, and its binary representation is 0, 0, 0. So, group G naught comprising of 0 number of 1s, which has only one term, that is M naught. Next, we will list all min terms with single 1s. So, we have M2, which is equal to 0, 0, 1, 0. Next, M8, which is 1, 0, 0. So, group G1 comprising of 1 number of 1s. Next, we will consider G2 with two ones. So, we have M3, which is 0, 0, 1, 1. And next, we have M6, which is 0, 1, 1, 0. Next, we have is M10, 1, 0, 1, 0. And we have is M12, 1, 1, 0, 0. So, this are all the next set of minterms with two number of ones. Next, we will consider group 3 with three number of ones. So, we have M7, which is 0, 1, 1, 1. And we have M13, that is 1, 1, 0. So, first we have listed all the minterms and their binary representation. Next, we have sorted them into groups. G0 comprising of 0 number of minterms with 0 ones, G1 comprising of minterms with 1 number of ones, G2 comprising of minterms with 2 number of ones, and G3 comprising of minterms with 3 number of ones. So, the next step is compare each minterm in every group with every minterm in the adjacent group. So, we are comparing each minterm of G0 with every other minterm of G1, and G1 with all the minterms of G1 with all the minterms of G2, and all minterms of G2 with G3. And while comparing, we will group them if at all they differ by one bit position. If there is a difference in one bit position, we will consider and we will copy them into the next column. So, while grouping, what we are trying to do is we are trying to eliminate the variables, simplifying the expressions. And finally, once further simplification or grouping is not possible, we stop and we end up listing all the prime implicants. So, what we do here is I compare M0 with M2, M0 with M8, and check if it is differing by one bit position. If it is differing by one bit position, I will copy it onto the next column. So, what we do here is, again, minterm binary representation. So, 0 with 2, it differs by only this bit position. Please note, everywhere else it is same, it is differing only in this bit position. Because there is a single bit position, we copy it onto the next column. So, it happens to be 0, 2. And while copying it to the next column, you just put a check mark indicating that this has been accounted for. Or otherwise, this becomes in prime implicant. So, if at all any minterm is not carried on to the next column, it should be considered as a prime implicant, or otherwise this will be accounted for. So, we need to indicate it by a check mark. And while writing its binary representation, replace the bit position where the difference is by a dash or a don't care. So, this is to be replaced by a don't care or a dash. So, I will write this as 00-0 because it is differing in this bit position. I replace it with a dash. Now, I compare 0 and 8. It is again differing by this bit position. I copy it onto the next column and this happens to be -0, 0, 0. Now, I am done with comparing G0 with G2. Now, we will compare with G1. All minterms of G1 with all minterms of G2 and see if they can be merged. Now, M2 and M3, yes, they differ only by this bit position. I need to carry it. So, 2, 3 happens to be 0 0 1 dash. Now 2 comma 6, it is not differing by one bit position, don't carry. 2 and 10, yes, it is differing by one bit position. So it is dash 0 1 0. Next 2 and 12, it is not differing by one bit position, we will not copy. So next 8 and 10, it is not differing by one bit position, no need to carry. 8 and 6, no, it is not differing by one bit position, don't carry. 8 and 10, yes, it is differing by one bit position. So that is 1 0 dash 0. It is differing in this bit position, so we replace it with a dash. And 8 and 12, it is differing by one bit position, that is the second bit position, second most significant bit position, we will carry. So 8 comma 12 happens to be 1 dash 0 0. Now I am done with comparing all elements of G1 with all elements of G2, all minterms of G2. Now we will continue comparing G2, all minterms of G2 with G3. So now just check 3 and 7, yes, it differs by one bit position, carry it. 3 comma 7, so it happens to be 0 dash 1 1. Now compare 3 and 13, it is not differing, we will not copy. Next 6 and 7, yes, it varies by one bit position, 6 comma 7, it is 0 1 1 dash. Now 6 and 13, it is not varying by one bit position, don't copy. Now we compare 10 and 7, it is not varying by one bit position, don't copy. And when it comes to 10 and 13, yes, it varies by it is not varying by one bit position, don't copy. Next we compare 12 and 7, it is not varying by one bit position, don't carry. So 12 and 13, yes, it is varying by one bit position, I will copy it to the next column. So it becomes 1 1 0 dash. So we are done. All the minterms in this column has been carried on to the next column. We go on doing this till we arrive at a point wherein further grouping or merging is not possible. Again, what I do, I group it into 0 number of ones, 1 number of ones, and 2 number of ones. Now again I just compare this all minterms in this group with all minterms in the next adjacent group, all minterms in this group with all minterms in the next adjacent group, and we will continue this till for further simplification is possible. So at this point you have seen one variable has been eliminated, and when I do it, when I take it one more step ahead, one more variable will be eliminated. You can see your C has been eliminated, your A has been eliminated, your D has been eliminated, and so on. So when I carry forward it to the next column, one more variable will be eliminated. So we have again minterm so 0 2 2 3, it is not varying by one bit position, we will not carry. 0 2 and 2 10, it is not varying by one bit position, we will not carry. 0 2 and 8 10, yes, it is varying by one bit position, this bit position, so I will carry to the next column. 0 2 8 10, and replace the bit position which is differing by a dash, so this happens to be dash 0 dash 0. While copying it to the next column, put a check mark indicating it has been accounted for. Next 0 2 8 10, it is not varying by one bit position, no need to carry. Now compare 0 8 and 2 3, it is not varying by one bit position, don't copy. 0 8 and 2 10, it is already been accounted for, so you just check, it is going to be dash 0 dash 0, it is the same, so it has already been accounted, so you just put a check mark. 0 8 and 2 10, it has already been accounted for. And 0 8 8 10, no, there is no single difference, so we will not copy it. And 0 8 8 12, it again does not differ by only one bit position, don't copy. Now we are done with comparing all minterms of first group with the second group. Now we will continue comparing the second group with the third group. So 2 3 and 3 7, no, it does not vary by one bit position, no need to carry. 2 3 and 6 7, yes, it varies by one bit position, 2 3 6 7, so you can see it is 0 dash 1 dash 0 dash 1 dash. Now compare 2, 3 and 12, 13. No, it is not varying by 1 bit position, no need to copy. Now I compare 210 and 37. 210 and 37, it is not varying by 1 bit position, don't copy. 210 and 67, no, it is not varying by 1 bit position, we will not carry. And 210 and 1213, no, it is not varying by 1 bit position, no need to copy. 810 and 37, it is not varying by 1 bit position, no need to copy. 810 and 67, it is not varying by 1 bit position, no need to copy. 810 and 1213, it is not varying by 1 bit position, no need to copy. Again, coming to 812 and 37, no, it is not varying by 1 bit position. 812 and 67, it is not varying by 1 bit position. And coming to 812 and 1213, with 37 not common, 67 not common, 1213 not common. So this happens to be a prime implicant, this is a prime implicant, and further simplification is not possible. You just compare it where it is more than 1 bit position, we will stop at this point. Now this ends up being a prime implicant, this is a prime implicant, and these two are the prime implicants. So first what we do is we will make a list of all the prime implicants and then go with the second step, wherein we will try to identify the essential prime implicants of out of the generated prime implicants. So what I am trying to do here is I will list all the prime implicants here. So we have A, B has been eliminated, C bar and D bar. So A, C bar and D bar, and the min terms are 8 and 12. It is corresponding to min terms 8 and 12. And this is also a prime implicant because it has not been further simplified. And this is A, B and C bar. The min terms are 12 and 13. And coming to this, it is B bar, D bar. Min terms are 0, 2, 8, and 10. And coming to this term, the min terms are A bar C, literals are A bar C, and min terms are 2, 3, 6. So this is the first step. Let me briefly or quickly run through what we have done so far. So you are given with the expression, by write the min terms and their binary representation. We sort them according to number of ones, group them as G0, G1, G2 and so on. Now we compare every element, every min term in each group with every other min term in the adjacent group and carry it to the next column by merging them, if at all they differ by 1 bit position. So we have done this. We go on doing this till further simplification is not possible. And once you are done with all merging, you list out all the prime implicants. So those which has not been carry forwarded are also to be considered as prime implicant. This is a prime implicant. This is a prime implicant. 3, 7 has been accounted for. This is a prime implicant. This is a prime implicant, and these two are prime implicants. We have listed 4 prime implicants. Now, what we are supposed to do is we need to identify the essential prime implicants out of this prime implicants, identified prime implicants. Now, what we will try to do is we will write one more table and try to identify essential prime implicants. So, we will write one more table which is used for identifying essential prime implicants. So the A C bar D bar, A B C bar, B bar D bar and A bar C. So we will list out all the min terms. We have M0, M2, M3, M6, M7, 8, 10, 12 and 13. So we will just put a check mark on all the minterms corresponding to each prime implicant. So A, C bar, D bar, we have minterm 8 and 12. And for the next prime implicant, we have as 12 and 13. And for the next prime implicant, we have 0, 2, 8 and 10. Next we have is 2, 3, 6. Now we need to identify essential prime implicants, and to do so we go with trial and error approach. So each solution, it is not necessary that it has only one unique solution. You could have two or more solution, and you will have to use trial and error approach to arrive at each possible solution. Now what I try to do here is, you can see 13 is a min term which is not covered by any of the prime implicants. So essentially this becomes an essential prime implicant. If I skip this, I will be losing min term 13. So this is to be considered as essential prime implicant. Just put a vertical column to all those min terms which is covered by this. So this is covered, 12 is covered. So 12 need not be covered by any other min term. So now what I do is I identify 2, so identify 10. 10 is a min term. If I skip this particular prime implicant, I will be losing 10. So what I do, I will consider this as an essential prime implicant and draw a vertical line to all those which are covered using this. So you can now look, by including, by making these two as essential prime implicant, I am covering 8 and 12, which are the prime implicants corresponding to AC bar, D bar. This becomes a redundant term, so I will not include this. And coming to A bar C, we have 3, 6 and 7, which is not covered by any other prime implicant. So this again becomes an essential prime implicant. And accordingly, this equation reduces to this particular given Boolean expression, simplifies us to A bar C plus B bar D bar plus A B C. So this is how we simplify a given Boolean expression using Quinn-McCluskey method. Basically two steps. First step is to identify the prime implicants, and the second table or second step wherein we write a table and try to identify essential prime implicants. So we will all consider how to deal with don't care terms in incompletely specified function. If at all your expression is an incompletely specified expression including don't cares, how this is to be dealt, we will have a look into it. Now we will consider one more example wherein it has don't care terms. So it has min terms 2, 3, 7, 9, 11, 13 along with don't care terms 1, 10 and 15. How this can be simplified using Quinn-McCluskey method, we will just try to see. So now while applying Quinn-McCluskey method to simplify this Boolean expression, the first table does not do any biasing. It treats don't care as well as min terms equally well in identifying all the prime implicants. And while identifying essential prime implicants, we will skip mentioning of don't care terms. So we will consider don't care terms as well as min terms as well and try to simplify. The first step we go on as usual as we did in the previous class, but while identifying the essential prime implicants, we will not make a mention of the don't care terms. Okay. Now we have an expression with don't care terms. So we list all the min terms and their binary representation. We have one. We consider don't care as well to identify the prime implicants initially. So I have included don't care as min term here. So it is M1, M2, M3, M7, 9, 10, 11, 13, 15. I have written their binary representation 1, 2, 3, so on. So now we sort them according to, we arrange them into groups depending on the number of ones. So first we have group 1 containing 1 number of ones, group 2 containing 2 number of ones, 3 containing 3 number of ones and 4 number of ones. So we compare every min term of each group with every min term of the adjacent group and we carry it to the next column if at all it differs by 1 bit position. Now you compare 1 and 3, you can see it is differing in this bit position. So we carry it to the next column 1, 3. by replacing the bit position which is airing by a don't care or a dash. So it is 00-1. Now compare 1 and 9, yes it varies by 1 bit position, this bit position, this bit position I carry it to the next column 1, 9, it becomes dash 001. So we move, go on doing this, 2 and 3 compare, it is varying by 1 bit position, carry it to the next column 001 dash, replacing the bit position which is differing by a dash. Now we have 2, 9 is not common, will not carry, and 210 as it varies by 1 bit position, replace the position by a dash and carry to the next column, it happens to be dash 010. Now we are done with comparing all minterms of first group with the second group. We will continue comparing all minterms of second group with the third group. Now compare 3 and 7, yes it varies by this bit position, replace that bit position by a dash and carry it to the next column. So while carrying it to the next column, make sure you put a check mark indicating that it has been accounted for. Now compare 3 and 11, yes it varies by 1 bit position, this bit position, replace that bit position by a dash and carry it to the next column, it happens to be 0-011. Now 3 and 13 does not vary by 1 bit position, we will not carry. Compare 9 and 7, no. 9 and 11, yes, carry. 9 and 13, yes, carry. Now coming to 10 and 7, it does not vary by 1 bit position, no need to carry. 10 and 11 does not vary by 1 bit position, no carry. 10 and 11, yes, it varies by 1 bit position, this bit position, we carry 1-01. And 10 and 13, it is not varying by 1 bit position, don't carry. Now I am done comparing all elements in terms of this group with this group. I continue with the next groups, that is this group with this group, with this group. Obviously all elements do vary by 1 bit position. So it is 7 and 15, 11 and 15 and 13 and 15, it becomes dash 111 and 1-11 and 1-1. Replace the bit position which is varying by a dash or a don't care and carry it to the next column. Now I again group them into number of ones. So we have 1 number of ones, 2 number of ones and 3n number of ones. Now I go on comparing each element of each group with the adjacent, or with every other element of the adjacent group. Now if you compare 1, 3 and 3, 7, no. 1-3-3-11, no. 1-3-9-11, yes, it varies by 1 bit position. We have carried it here. So it is dash 0-1-1. Now compare 1-3 with 9-13, no. 1-3 with 10-11, no, it does not vary by 1 bit position. Now I compare 1-9 and 3-7, no. 1-9 and 3-11, yes, it does vary. Put a check mark and it is the same. Dash 0-1-. Now 1-9 with 9-11, no. 1-9 with 9-13, no. 1-9 with 10-11, no. Now I go on comparing 2-3 with 3-7, no. 2-3 with 3-11, no. 2-3 with 9-11, no. 2-3 with 9-13, no. And 2-3 with 10-11, yes, it varies by 1 bit position. And that is this one. So replace it with dash 0-1-. We have copied it to the next column. Now compare 2-10 with 3-7, no. 2-10 with 3-11, yes, it varies. Put a check mark and carry it. It is again, it has already been accounted for and it is dash 0-1-. Now 2-10 with 9-13, no. 2-10 with 10-11, no. We stop at this point. And now we will compare all elements of this group with this group. And you can see 3-7 with 7-15, no. 3-7 with 11-15, yes, it has been accounted for. And 3-7 with 13-15, no. 3-11 with 7-15, yes, it has already been accounted. We put a check mark. And 3-11 with 11-15, no. 3-11 with 13-15, no. 9-11 with 7-15, no. 9-11 with 11-15, no. 9-11 with 13-15, yes, it has been carried. And 9-13 with 7-15, no. 9-13 with 11-15, yes, put a check mark and go. And 10-11 with not accounted for. 10-11 with 7-15, no. 10-11 with 11-15, no. And 10-11 with 13-15, no. So we end up carrying all the prime implicants in this column to the next column. As a result, we have listed the prime implicants. These are the prime implicants which we have arrived at. And this corresponds to minterm 1-3-9-11. That is B bar D, and this corresponds to minterm 2, 3, 10 and 11. This corresponds to minterm 3, 7, 11, 15, and this corresponds to minterm 9, 11, 13, 15. So the next step is to identify the essential prime implicants. We again write one more table and use trial and error approach to identify the main terms. But please note one difference: what is to be taken care of when you have don't care terms is, while writing the table for identifying the essential prime implicants, skip mentioning of these don't cares at the top. Only mention the min terms which are in the expression. Don't include this, and then try to identify the essential prime implicants. Now we have listed all the prime implicants here, and we have listed only the min terms. We are not including the don't cares, because don't cares, they are not part of do not influence the output. So we don't include the don't cares here. So B bar, D bar, the prime implicants corresponding to B bar, first prime implicant, that is B bar, D bar, are 1 is not there, 3, 9 and 11. And coming to B bar C, it is 2, 3, 10 is not there and 11. And coming to CD, it is 3, 7, 11 and 15. And next we have AD is 9, 11 and 13. Now we use trial and error method to identify which are all the essential prime implicants, and it is very obvious. M2 is not covered by any other prime implicant. This is an essential prime implicant. So next, if you look into CD, we have M7 which is not covered by any other prime implicant, so we make this essential prime implicant. And coming to AD, we have M13 which is not covered in any other prime implicant, so we will consider this as essential prime implicant. So now you just make an observation. So including AD, CD and B bar C covers all the min terms. So this becomes a redundant term, and this may not be considered as an essential prime implicant, and this expression reduces to B bar C plus CD plus, and this is how we simplify a given expression comprising of don't care terms. So what we do is, we the first step is done as usual by considering all the min terms and their prime implicants, and while identifying the essential term, essential prime implicants, don't make a mention of don't cares at the top. So we will consider only the prime implicants and try to identify only the min terms and try to identify the essential prime implicants. With this, we will stop here for today. In the next class, we will consider, we will propose one more method called as Petrick's method. So in as I said, when I use the Quinn-McCluskey method for simplifying a given expression, each trial and error approach can lead to different solution. So we need to go with trial and error method to identify the different possible solution. And now it may not, in this case we end up getting only one possible solution, and it may not be true that every method or every expression ends up getting only one possible solution. We could have multiple possible solutions. So we to have a systematic method of identifying all possible solution, we will go with what is called as Petrick's method. So it is a more systematic approach, wherein applying Petrick's method, we will get all possible solutions, and out of the all possible solution, we will try to identify only the minimum possible solutions. So in the next class, we will take up Petrick's method and one more topic, map entered variable, which expands your k-map by one degree. We will consider those two to conclude this particular module. Thank you.